Hello everybody and welcome back to Knavesworld Farm. So I'm in Fit Number 6 and this has kind of been converted over to my extra storage area for the farm. Because the long machines, for example, the Dominator and the long bale trailer, they're very difficult to manoeuvre around the tight sheds in the yard, so I think this is probably the best place for them. But also, I was getting so fed up of the header falling off the trailer, if I put it here, it'd be much easier to pick it up again. Now, it turns out that if you stop the game and reload it, the header will have fallen off, which is a bit unfortunate. So that is why it's here. I guess we don't actually need a header trailer, because the header is so small anyway, but I'm going to keep it like this for now, but I'm sure in a few episodes' time, I will be furious with this header trailer and this header. But yeah, we'll keep it on there for now. And yeah, the telehandler and the bale trailer can stay here as well. The good thing is, we own the field. So we can also move them out if we want to. We can mow the field as well. So no, we don't really have any pressure with regards to leaving stuff in here. And we've got a nice muddy entrance as well. So today's job is going to be slurry spreading in field number 25 and 24. And we're going to be using our Fendt 512 for this job. The only thing is, we don't have a slurry spreader, so we're going to have to buy one. Now, I think a lot of people have been requesting various slurry spreaders for me to use, and the common one is the Marshall one, which is actually a very good one to use, but I'm not going to use that today, because I've used it so many times before. It is a good one, the ST1800, but we're going to use a mod today because there are so many decent mods out there. I think it is about time that we did use a modded slurry spreader. So it is, if I can find the tab for it, here we go. It is the Red Rock 2250 and it's £23,000. It's quite expensive, but it should be good. So we're going to buy that and we're going to pick it up from the store. I think this tractor is the best one for the job because it isn't too big. But one thing I'd love to do in the future is to buy an extra, you know, a transport bowser for the slurry and take that to the field as well, because I think in no time I'm going to be getting quite annoyed by the amount of time it takes to go backwards and forwards from the yard, because the amount that it's got in the spreader depletes so fast. But we'll have to see. We'll have to see how it goes. So here we are. Already looking really good. There is one thing I want to just mention quickly, and that is the spreader we used last week. I have actually sold that spreader, and you're probably thinking, you are crazy, that is the best spreader ever. And it is. It really is the best one ever. But I have an issue with it, and it's not the mod itself, it's the owner of the mod. It has been unofficially converted by somebody, and, you know, just dispersed over the internet. And I don't think that's very fair, so I'm not going to use it because it's kind of against the rights of the author. From the person who has converted it over and distributed it, that is, you know, it's not good really. So I'm not going to support that. I'm not going to use it again, which is a shame because it is a good spreader. But the next best thing is the in-game one, but with the modifications, which means that you can still fold the sheet back, the cover over, and fill it up that way. It has the fertilizer plane inside, so you can see it filling up. So yeah, it's the next best thing. It's not animated, but it's still pretty good. But that is, I thought I might as well tell you, because if the spreader just randomly disappears one day, that would look pretty weird. Right, so what I'm gonna do, as you can see, it's filling up. I'm gonna jump out, and I'm gonna take a look in the pit. We won't have too much in here, no. It's like a little trickle at the bottom. But if we can do two fields, that would be fantastic. If you look on here, we should be able to see. Yeah, we have 36,000 litres of liquid manure. Obviously, we've already filled some up. But look at the detailing on here. So good. And I love the really chunky wheels at the back. 2250. Anyway, I'm guessing that will be full. It kind of looks too small on this tractor, actually. I'm surprised about its size. That is massive. I think there's either a scale problem with the tractor or with the spreader itself. Really don't know, though. Anyway, let's go over to furrow number 25 and begin. Yeah, it's a really good-looking mod, this. As you can see, the field is growing, so it does want to be fertilised. And the rain is forecast, so all of our fields which are fairly low on moisture, they will be watered very soon. The working width of this spreader is 10 metres, so it's not too bad. It's pretty good. We should be able to get the job done fairly quickly. But yeah, the fill level goes down so quickly. As you can see, the nutrients for this field is pretty bad. So is the soil moisture. In fact, everything about it is terrible. So we really need to boost that level again. And hopefully this is the way to do it. Hopefully I'm doing this right. As a lot of you will know, in the base game, in the vanilla version of Farming Simulator, you can't actually fertilise grass. But apparently you can with soil mod. So with a bit of luck, this is working. I thought it would look a bit ridiculous to use the artificial fertiliser spreader on here, so that is why I'm not doing. I think slurry is a great alternative to it. But yeah, it is going down relatively quickly. That field is really coming along. Should be harvesting it. I can see the spreader is slowly getting dirty through use as well. And we're virtually empty. But to be fair, that has actually gone quite a long way. It's very difficult to see where you've been, though. Right. The spreader is empty. Let's go and refill. Through the mud. It's a good job we're not too far away. Otherwise, this will take quite a long time to do. And eventually, I think we'll see the level go down in here. I don't know if this is... Yes, you can see it going down. So I'm guessing that if we have the cows for long enough, and we don't empty this, the pit will virtually overflow. It'll come right up to the top. Which would be quite impressive to see. How are we doing? We are full. So back to the field. This is going to be quite a repetitive job after a while, but at the moment, I'm really enjoying it. Look at the mud. Oh yeah, we do need to move the pressure washer as well, because as someone did quite rightly point out, it seems like a very strange thing to do, to wash your machinery in a puddle or in a bog. So that will have to be moved at some point, because it's crazy. It really is. And now it's just the centre of the field which needs to be done. It's amazing how in real life these farmers can do this perfectly. And then just because in Farming Simulator you can't see properly where you've been, it just makes it so difficult. It must be tough to be a farmer. I really do appreciate everything that is done by them, because there are so many jobs which have to be done, and you know, half of them must be very difficult to do. I mean, I struggle with Farming Simulator, and yeah, that's only a simulator. And I think that is this field done. It is hard to say, but I'm hoping that when the water, the rain, washes this in, we should get quite a nutritious field again, providing this has actually worked. I really do hope it has done. I think it would be a silly idea to go over to 24 straight away, because we've only got 37% in here. Oh, the mud is splashing up. Yeah, so what we'll do instead is refill it and then go there. It's about time we did this though. I've been really neglecting the grass fields, and to be honest, I think all of them would be terrible. So if we were to cut, for example, field number 6, it's going to be pretty terrible quality. I don't know if having a low nutrition level on the soil mod will affect the quality of a bale using the bale extension mod. It would be quite interesting to see, but obviously they are independent mods, so hard to say. Right, how much do we have left? We have got 19,000 litres, so just short of 2 more loads. So we should, well, I don't know, we might have enough. We might do. We'll just have to see. Right, field 24, just up there. Whoa, that is muddy. I don't think I've been in this field since the mud has been implemented, because the first version I got of this map, the mud wasn't in there. It is only in the public release, so yeah. It must have rained very heavily since to get all this mud in here. But this tractor is actually coping incredibly well. I'm yet to get it stuck. I think I'm just going to have to do as much as I can do, and then if there is anything left, we'll just have to leave that bit of the field until we have more. But I don't think it'll be too long until it starts to rain. So on the other side of the field there, we're getting the error message saying you don't own the field. If we were to buy field number 22, we would bypass that problem. So really, the ideal situation would be able to afford every single field and buy them all, because then we no longer get that annoying problem. But obviously we can't afford them, so we're going to have to just live with it. I think the best thing for me to do now is just go up and down the field. With the other field we did, I was going round in a circle because of the size of it, but with this field, it would be better to go up and down. Right, this is annoying. Let's switch that off. We're going to go and buy it because this is ridiculous. Here we go. And it's not even too expensive. That's better. So yeah, I think we probably did waste a bit there, but it's not the end of the world. I'm actually surprised how slow this field is at growing, because the other one was really quick. And we're almost out again, so we're going to have to head over to the yard and refill. I'd love to say we could get to the yard, but I'm actually stuck. I'm digging deeper. Oh no, this is not good. I think we're going to have to go for diff lock. I seriously need to get the chain mod, because I didn't realise you could actually get totally stuck. Oh, there we go. I think you probably can get totally stuck, we're going to have to back right out of here. Oh, we're digging deep. We are digging deep. Oh no, this is not good. Yes, we do need the chain mod. Quite urgently. And I think we're out. Good. That could have been quite bad. And now I have to be able to turn around to get out of here. That was close. Let's turn four-wheel drive off. Me and the mud mod have very rarely got along together because I always get stuck in it. Always. I think we're going to have four-wheel drive on here. Just to ensure we don't get stuck. Surprisingly muddy. Refilling for the second to last time. As you can see, it's getting quite empty in there. If we were to speed up time, they would produce it a lot quicker. But also, the soil mod could, you know, we could get some withered crops. In fact, I probably should check that. It's been a while since I've taken a look on here. But we seem to be okay. Obviously, these are growing. This one here is, I think that is the final stage of ready to harvest. Yes, that one there. But we don't own it, so is it true that a field you don't own can wither? Because I'm not too sure. It obviously isn't our problem if it does wither, but it would be a shame if we ever wanted to buy it. Turn four-wheel drive off again, and once again we'll head back to the field, and I'm going to definitely avoid that mud hole. So please do let me know your thoughts and opinions on Knaveswell Farm. Personally, I think this is probably the best map by Tomix55. It's certainly the most detailed, although I do like more. I like most maps for Farming Simulator. To be honest, if there's a map which I don't like, then it must be terrible. Because, yeah, most of them are pretty amazing. But yeah, this is certainly in my top 10, if not my top 5. I usually hate to say my top 5 because I'm bound to offend someone, because like if I've said, oh, your map's amazing and stuff, and I don't even say it's in top 5, that's, you know, that can be quite disappointing to hear. But one thing I definitely can say is every single map that I've played on for Farming Simulator 15 is definitely in my top 10, and they're all worth playing on because they're all very good in their own way. Right, let's finish off that bit there. I need to go here. But yeah, I think it is a very good map, and I can't believe the episode number we're already on. The time just flies, it's incredible. You know you're enjoying a map if you don't even know what episode you're on. That kind of sounds weird, but yeah. I could get to episode 60 or something and only think I've done about 30. But yeah, I think we'll have enough. I might not be spreading this with the best coverage ever, but at least, you know, the field is getting something at least half decent here. As long as I'm doing this right, I just hate for someone to say, oh, you've just done all that and it's not even going to work. Because, you know, I'm new to soil mod and I've never done fertilising on the grass before. So there is always the possibility I could get it wrong. But oh well, it's fun anyway. See, if I do get it wrong, I can always do it again off screen. And I think we're going to have enough here. It's actually holding on quite well. Quite a lot in here. But certainly an extra tanker would be very handy. That is our field completed. We do need to do some more mowing again in the future. I would love to rent the Big M, but you know, it's big. Is it too big? I might be pushing it a bit for this map, but yeah, I could do. I could get it. Just rent it. Anyway, we're going to head back to the yard, and I think we're going to call it a day. We've done quite a lot today, and I always love to use a different mod. The best thing for me to do will be to reverse this near to the slurry pit and keep it there. The barrel shredder should probably move. Yes, in fact that's what I'll do. I'll put the spreader over here and then move the shredder and put it in there. That is where the combine harvester used to be, but we've made space by moving it. So I can go here. Try not to block anything in too much. Pressure washer needs to be moved. There. Who would want to be a slurry spreader? It continually sits in poo. Yeah, we're at risk of getting stuck again here. But that is good for that. Let me just jump out and we will detach the PTO. No point washing it. There we go. And yes, let's get the bale shredder, put that in the shed, and that will at least tidy things up a tiny bit. So until next time, thank you for watching, hope you've enjoyed the video. Haven't done slurry spreading for quite a while, so it's nice to do something a bit new. Tomorrow I'm not really too sure what we're going to be doing, we'll have to wait and see, but until then, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye for now.